Mr. Gasser, man.
Mr. Gasser, man. This rat is known as real bad news.
So this is the place, Alpha Fired Arts, Sacramento, California. And this is my Fab Four. Okay, we're going to go to the warehouse and pick the clay up. I think that'll be enough. Well, I'm going to get another one.
I'm just getting that much.
Okay. It's my penance. Make a big sculpture. The piece is my final admission that I was very influenced by the artist of the 60s, the cartoon artist, and I never sort of really delved into it before. But I'm doing a portrait of Big Daddy Roth, who was the guy who made up Rat Fink, and he did a whole bunch of hot rods. He was sort of the beginning of the custom car movement. I'm going to do him holding one of his cars, sculpting one of his cars, and he'll have shoulders and a big head and a top hat. This is the model for the bigger sculpture. I always make a little model first so I can kind of conceptualize it visually, and then I do the bigger one. So I have to prepare the top of this clay to accept a wetter piece of clay. So what I do is I make a glue on the clay, rough it up. And the clay I've been using actually lately is, it has paper pulp in it, and it allows me to, the clay to stay together much better. And it stays wetter longer, so it doesn't crack as easy. And when I go to move it, it's much stronger. And I'm just stretching this out a little bit because I cut it off a little thick. And so I'm just thinning it out a little. I'm just gonna rough up the bottom edge. And I place it in place. And I'm gonna cut off another slab and put it all together. Make sure that every seam is covered. And that's about it for today. My teachers always said to me, make sculptures of what you're passionate about, what you love, or what you hate, but passion. So I thought, you know, what do I really love as far as art goes? You know, I thought, oh, well, maybe I'll go back to the German Expressionists or the Impressionists. And I thought, you know, what I really love is a nice car by Big Daddy Roth. You know, I just thought, but I can't do that because all that is just illustration and it's just lightweight stuff. And I thought, you know, but I love it and I can't help myself. And I feel a little silly going back to high school and what turned me on to high school, but it's still with me all these years later. And I think, well, I gotta really delve into this.
It was one of those scenes that you don't want to meet, when Gasser the passer went down in defeat. We were all broken up to see our champ take gas, but at last he met a chick that he couldn't pass.
So I'm here refining Big Daddy Roth's face. Just working on the lip here, trying to get this to curve. I need to make it curve around more. Okay. So we're moving along here. I'm doing the sculpture of Rat Fink, which is ultimately going to go on Big Daddy's head, coming out of his hat. I read a little interview with Big Daddy that he was upset that he was so obsessed with custom cars and Rat Fink that it was driving him crazy. So I thought, well, why don't I literally have Rat Fink driving Big Daddy. The kind of paint I'm using is a low fire glaze, commercial glaze. Comes out pretty much the same every single time, so I can really rely on it. Oops. So these kilns, the firing goes to 1986, and it takes about 8 hours for them to go up and about 12 hours for them to come down. And when I get them out, it's Christmas. I'm going to put the piece together now. Everything is in pieces so that I can move them around easy for shipping and just moving them from show to show. Okay, here goes the hat. And here comes Rat Fink.